Okay, welcome back, students. This is the 15th lesson from pre-Eastern Government, and we have been talking about the education development during the colonial period in Kenya. And the development we've been talking about are development in terms of education and in terms of health. And we have introduced education. I just want us to see how missionary came to be, or how missionary came up with some of the developed or some of the schools. And some even talked about, previously we talked about some of the schools that were established by the missionary. And they just want us to proceed from where we stopped last time. So, from 1925, the missionaries began providing advanced level education to Africans. Having in mind that previously we talked about how the missionaries started education and the program they started. They started the elementary, where the education was only provided to the young ones or to the lower grades. And with time, they saw the need to add other levels of education. And thereafter, there was introduction of high school, the introduction of primary school, and later universities. So we and talked about all the way from elementary to high school, but still we are talking about the high school, and we are trying to identify such schools by names. So that is what we want to look at. Then thereafter we'll be looking at the area which is very important as far as exams is concerned, and that is achievements of missionary in provision of education. And we talked about previously that there were groups who provided education, not only missionaries in Kenya during the colonial period, but apart from missionaries, there were also a colonialist with the help of the council, the government council within the country, and also there were education being provided by the Asian, that is Asian community, and also Africans themselves. So there were four groups who were providing education during the colonial period in Kenya. But then we are still talking about the British. So let's proceed. So initially secondary education was reserved the Europeans. So long time Africans were only being educated up to, or being educated up to a certain level. Then the secondary was a preserved for them. For the what? For the whites or for the British in Kenya. Then in 1926 the Alliance of Protestants Missionaries set up Alliance High School. So in this year, 1926, that's where Alliance High School was set up by the missionaries, that was under Alliance of Protestants Missionary. And also the Catholic established Kaba in 1927, and Mangu School in Thika in 1930 for Africans. So these one Catholics were established, or they were constructed for Africans by the missionary for the first time, because they realized that Africans or the Africans were not having what? They were not having authority to continue with the high school. Then there later in that the Protestant missionaries set up Alliance, which was also allowing the African also, and also Catholic was also established. The Catholic also established a school known as Kaba and also Manu for the Africans. So in 1938, in 1939, Maseno School and St. Mary's Yala also, these are schools, were also started as secondary schools, and Africans also were allowed to go. That's why if you look at the first renowned Africans who were educated, those people who came out to be great leaders, who were having knowledge in various fields that they ventured in before, we find that they were the products of these great schools that started at first, that was started at first within. Then, let's look at the achievements of missionary in provision of education. What did they achieve? I know, having in mind that you know the aims, we have the aims that made the missionaries to start or to establish education. Out of those aims, we are not supposed to diversify ourselves from what achievement is. We are not supposed to differ, because the aim goes hand in hand with achievement. What you aim at will be achievement in one way or the other. So one of the children that they design a curriculum with emphasis on agriculture, tailoring, mission, machinery, and carpentry. So for all these Africans who are obtaining education from the missionary schools, the curriculum was designed. These people were having these skills in agriculture, there were skills in tailoring, there were skills in machinery, and also skill in carpentry. So that was one of the achievements within their provision of education. Then another, they offered the missionary financial and material support to make this school operational. So necessary financial and material support to make this. So that was another achievement that was carried out by the missionary. Then the next one is that they established the first secondary school for Africans, such as Alliance in 1926. You can see that Gabon, Maseno, Yala, that is St. Mary's, Yala. So these are some of the first secondary that was built for Africans by the missionaries. And that was an achievement. Then the next, they trained African teachers to man the bush school. Man is like managing or maintaining the bush school. In brackets, school found in remote areas. So the school which are found in remote areas were known as the bush school. So they train Africans to manage these schools in remote areas consisting of mud huts with a grass thatched roof. Those are schools which are kind of looking this way. You can see this is mud thatched. When you say mud thatched, this is what? Then grass what? The grass touched, this is the grass touched, and the mud. Then the mud huts. This is made of mud, this is grass hut. So those schools in the remote areas, they were looking this way. And the missionary trained the Africans, fellow African as teachers to go and maintain that. So that was another achievement. And teach them the independent, or also they teach in the independent school. Now independent school, this was the school that were opened by the Africans themselves. And we'll be talking about later. After some of the Africans obtaining the skill that was required from the missionaries, they required themselves by including some of the African culture in starting or opening new schools and operating in their own way, combining all the African cultures and also the missionaries' rules and the regulation. Then they are the people who are ruling those schools, and they were known as independent schools. So this independent school provided a very mass effect in even spreading or passing the information on the struggle for the independence. Then the next that we are supposed to talk about is that secondary school for whites included Prince of Wales. Now after knowing the African schools by then being established by the missionary, the Alliance School, the Man, the St. Mary's, Yala, the Kaba, those renowned best schools. There was other schools that were always segregated for the white, and that is missionary. The first one was secondary school for white was included the Prince of Wales. That was the Nairobi school. You could not find the white in Africa there. It was only preserved for the white. Then also the Duke of York. Duke of York was the Lenana. The Prince of Wales was Nairobi school. It's changed after these people going back to the world, going back to their home after the independence. So for European boys and also Kenyan girls high school, that is Kenya high, then also Limuru girls for the European girls. Then school for Indians included the Asian Railway School. So the Asian Railway School was for Asian and other school developed by the government in Mombasa and Nairobi. So also community-based school like Alidina, Visram, this was a community-based school. And also the Arya Samaj Foundation. These are the schools that were established by the Asian. And I know the date has, they are still there. So these are the schools that were established by what? By the Asian. So let's make this be the end of the first of this. Let's proceed from the next part of the video. Thank you.